It has been said that the more you want, the more you spend. The more you spend, the more you need. The more you need, the more you have to have. And the more you have, the more you worry. And friends, you realize that the more you have, the more you can lose. In fact, Ecclesiastes 5, King Solomon, the richest man of the ancient world, said this in verse 13 and verse 14. He said, "There is severe evil which I have seen under the sun. Riches kept for their owner to his hurt, but those riches perish through misfortune." In other words, he is warning us not to be living to store up treasures in this life primarily, but we should be living to store up treasures in the next life. Why? Because the more you have in this life, the more in this life you can lose. But if you invest your treasures in the next life, in the next life, they'll never be lost. I read recently of the casino magnate Steve Wynn, who in 1997 purchased Pablo Picasso's painting, The Dream, for a mere $47 million. Less than 10 years later, Wynn completed a deal to sell that painting for $139 million. What a profit. The transaction would have set a record for the sale of a piece of art. It would have, except Wynn, who was standing close to the painting, turned and accidentally punctured the painting with his elbow, putting a 6-inch hole right in the middle of Picasso's masterpiece. As you could well imagine, the deal was off, and in an instant, Steve Wynn lost a potential $139 million. Because, you see, the more you have, the more you can lose. And friends, do you realize the more you have, the more we leave behind? In fact, Solomon warned of that in verse 15 of Ecclesiastes chapter 5. When he said these words, he said, "And as he came from his mother's womb, naked, he said, shall he return to go as he came. And he shall take nothing from his labor, which he may carry away in his hand." In other words, friends, we cannot take our wealth with us from this life to the next life. That's what Jesus Christ meant, and that's why he was warning us with these words. "Do not lay up for yourself treasures on earth, where moth and rust destroy, and where thieves break in and steal." You see, since earthly investments result in a life of emptiness and ultimate wastefulness, since the more you have, the more you want, the more you spend, the more you worry, the more you lose, and considering we can't take our wealth with us, we need to be making heavenly investments because they result in a life of personal and eternal blessedness. May every one of us be investing in eternity for the glory of God. May the Spirit of God take His word and bless you today.